What is up, guys? My name is Mark Sanmaria. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the RC vlog. Oh, sorry, the camera's moving a lot. Today we're doing a Tech Tuesday. We're at the track, but I got to change my motor and my spec slash because I want to put the water broken motor in. But I want to show you guys how to do some gear mesh. So a lot of people don't know how to do gear mesh, and that's why they strip gears, or their car sounds like crap, or it just strips gears, or this car sounds like anything can happen when you don't mesh the gears correctly. But I'm going to show you guys how to do it. I'm also going to do it the way they recommend it, and they being like the Traxxas recommends it and other RTR companies recommend. But yeah, because I'm gonna have to remesh these gears after I put the new motor in. So let's get to taking this thing out. All right, guys, here's the gears in a spec slash. So this isn't mesh right now. So what I do is I basically screw this top screw in. This top screw doesn't move, so I screw it in just where it's kind of just a little bit snug, but I can move it. And this bottom one I keep loose. But the very first thing you wanna do is you wanna screw the motor in where it's flush with the motor plate. That way you can line the gear up. You want the pinion and the spur gear to be perfectly lined up. So I have it, I don't know if you guys can see that. I wonder if I tap the screen or something. No. So I am gonna line it up real quick, and then I'm gonna tighten the pinion onto the motor. All right, so I tightened it up. Make sure you have Loctite on the screw. The Traxxas set screws already have Loctite on them. And now you can see how it's basically perfectly lined up with the spur gear and pinion. And luckily, because this is a Traxxas pinion, Traxxas spur gear, they're the same width. If it's not the same width, just make sure the most, like, you can get the most of your most contact you possibly can between the two gears. So I already kind of know how to mesh, but the way they tell you how to mesh is you get the basically, I'm gonna do this one-handed. You get this away, you basically pull them apart, and then you put a piece of paper between the gears, and then you shove the gears together and then tighten the motor, and then when you pull the paper out, that should be perfect mesh. I'm not a big fan of that because these 48 pitch pinions and 48 pitch gears, I feel like that might be too much gap, but we're gonna do it like this anyways, and we're gonna see what it looks like, and I'll tell you if I think it's good, and I'll show you what I do. All right, I shoved the paper in between, I shoved the gears together, and now I'm just gonna remove this. Let's see. I mean, that's not bad. Actually, that's not a bad little thing. I figured they knew what they were doing, but that mesh looks actually pretty good. So the idea is you want a little bit of play here. Like, you don't want it to be super tight. A lot of people just mesh it together and they're good. You don't want to do that. That's how you strip things. This actually doesn't look bad at all. After I tighten the motor down, it looks like it moved the pinion out, so I'm going to line the pinion one more time. And that is not bad at all. So yeah, the paper trick does work. Just get a piece of paper and put it between the gears, shove them together as hard as you can, and then tighten the gears up, and then pull the piece of paper out, and that's like a perfect mesh. That's not bad at all. I like that. Okay, let me go tighten this up. All right, guys, I'm not gonna lie, I don't think it was good enough. I felt like there was a little too much space there. One thing you wanna do is you kinda wanna spin the gear a little bit, because there are some spots, some of these gears aren't made perfect, so some spots are a little bit higher than others, so you wanna make sure that it meshes everywhere around. See, now mine's meshed, and there's just a little bit of play, which is exactly how you want it, but you wanna make sure at least the meaty part of the gears are touching. Not too much play. When I say the slightest bit, so much where it's free, but there's not too much play. It's hard to explain, but this is where I like it right there. So I think the paper trick would work if you're doing mod 1 gearing, but for this, in this particular case, I think for the 48 pitch pinions, you need to kind of play it by, you know, do it yourself. Get it tight enough and make sure there's just the slightest bit of play. And when I say slightest bit, that's like 0.2 of a millimeter of play. So that is how you mesh, guys. After you get done meshing, let me fit the battery. It shouldn't be loud. So a lot of people, they mesh and it's like extremely loud. It shouldn't be loud. It should sound really smooth. If it is loud, it's usually because your gears are chopped up or you're missing teeth or something. But I'll show you what mine sounds like now. See? Perfect. Ooh, that water broken motor. That thing is legit. So I hope that helps, guys. If it did, smash like button, subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification bell, and you guys will see me next time. Later, guys.